There's a ton of fuel left out there.
Tons of fuel. Small, dry balls of fire that keep the St. Johns County wildfire going and going and going.
You have a lot of palmetto out there, a lot of pine needles, which is very, are fine fuels, which is very easy to set ablaze.
This is a good line in here.
It's a problem they've fought all day. Small fires that break away from larger ones.
And they're still hot, they're embers, and they go, you know, quarter, half mile out, and they start another spot fire.
And high winds, averaging 15 to 20 miles per hour, with gusts up to 25, that have carried them in every direction.
With the winds that are coming out of the northwest this morning, switching out of the north this afternoon, and coming back around to the northeast this afternoon, that's our concern, is making sure that south line is secure.
Crews from multiple agencies in surrounding counties are using air patrols to monitor hotspots, bulldozers to build barriers around them. Most have sparked up along the south side of the fire line, this one just off US 1, south of Matanzas State Forest.
They're going to be using the tractor plows to actually plow out those areas right now, so there is a fire line around it.
The Culhane sisters are a tight bunch. There are four of them. But if you ask them, they'll tell you they had a fifth sister, Kay Lamb.
She was everything we were proud of, and she was definitely a proud Irish woman.
But tonight, that proud Irish woman they knew so well isn't at the Culhane sisters' restaurant. On Christmas Eve, Kay was hit by a car while crossing Seminole Road in Atlantic Beach. She died 2 days later.
We're just devastated, and we feel her loss. I mean, her spirit was just, it was amazing.
It's what brought in a steady crowd of regulars to the restaurant, including former Jaguars football coach Tom Coughlin. Kay was a big football fan, so she just had to get this picture with him.
She was well-loved.
As the Culhane sisters think back to their time with Kay, they remember the special bond they all shared. They're all natives of Ireland, and over the last 4 years, they become especially close.
She was there for all of us at different points in our lives, you know, weddings, funerals, births. I mean, it was just a privilege, really, to know her.
There's now a memorial of flowers and pictures of Kay in the entrance of the restaurant, a place Kay Lamb will definitely be missed.
My goodness, she was one in a million. I don't think we'll ever, ever be the same again here.
Everywhere you look, and everywhere you turn in Dino Alive, you see a childhood favorite.
From what we know about dinosaurs, these are the same size as the dinosaurs that were around 65 million years ago.
Jacksonville Zoo's new exhibit features a 1,200-foot trail through the dino woods, and all the favorites like Brachiosaurus, Triceratops, and of course, the star of the show, T-Rex.
I used to call him the Michael Jordan of dinosaurs.
In addition to the moving animals, there's an igloo for kids and an area for an archaeological dig. If you still aren't impressed, stand by the Dilophosaurus and get an H2O surprise. Young or old, there's something for everyone, especially the young at heart who never lose joy in the largest animals to walk the earth.
This dinosaurs is not a fad. Every little kid always loves dinosaurs. So yeah, we expect this to be a big, big hit with the kids in town.
Tim Callahan loved flag football. He played every Saturday for 15 years. But that changed one Saturday in July.
This stuff never happened. This is a one in a million accident.
Tim went for the ball like he had so many times and collided with another player, but this time was different.
He landed on top of my head and he pushed my head into my chest and broke my neck.
A devastating injury, playing what should have been a safe sport.
This is a non-contact thing. It's not supposed to happen.
Tim knew right away what had happened on the field was serious.
I was paralyzed instantly from the neck down, couldn't move.
So he did what he could do. Pray.
I started to pray right away. I mean, I knew God was the only one that could help me right then and there. And I did. I promise I got a warm feeling over me. And my wife is really funny. She told me a couple weeks later, she's like, she got kind of like the same warm feeling.
Tim says that warm feeling was reassurance from God that he was going to be okay, even though the situation was bad. He needed a ventilator to breathe, a feeding tube to eat, and a halo to keep his head still. As if that were not enough, doctors told him he had little chance of ever walking again.
A lot of nurses, a lot of doctors told my wife, you know, during the time that I probably would never walk again.
But Tim wasn't the kind of guy to back down from a challenge. So he shocked his doctors when just 3 weeks later, he took these emotional first steps, all caught on home video. I dare you to move. Tim was walking, defying the odds that he would be a quadriplegic for life.
I actually saw my surgeon the other day. He told me that, you know, he was explaining to some of his other nurses and stuff there that, you know, they gave me a 0.01% chance to walk, and I was that 0.01%.
He's a modern-day medical miracle, and he says his recovery is proof that through faith and family, anything is possible. Karen Adams, CBS 47, Action News.
Ken Decker rides his bike everywhere. To cool down, he drinks a lot of water.
It's good for you. It purges the body, keeps all the toxins out.
But a website called 24/7 Wall Street reports that Jacksonville water is full of chemicals. The group ranked Jacksonville 10th on the list for the worst water in the country. The website used data from an organization called Environmental Working Group. The group tested samples of water from our city and found large amounts of toxic chemicals, including cleaning products. If that makes you want to spit out your water, JEA says not so fast.
Well, to begin with, it's not a comprehensive study, and they're not comparing apples to apples. Certainly, with the thousands of tests that we do every month and supply to our regulators shows that our drinking water is safe.
We have drinking water samples that come here.
We went inside the JEA lab to see for ourselves. This is where they test 2,000 samples of water every month for unsafe levels of chemicals in our drinking water. If they detect anything, JEA says they fix the problem.
This is an essential service that we provide, and we work very hard to make sure that it's safe.
So that folks like Ken Decker can cool down with some drinking water and not worry about getting sick. The sick and dead birds are being brought here to a sanctuary on Big Talbot Island, where they're trying to figure out what happened. It's been a tough winter for pelicans living along the St. John's River. Hundreds of them have been discovered dead or sick. Cindy Mosling is the founder of the Bird Emergency Aid and Care Sanctuary, or BEACS.
It's horrible. You know, I do this because I love the birds. I do this because I followed my heart. And it's like, if you care about something, you want to see suffering and dying.
She says two factors that could be contributing to the birds' deaths are contamination in the St. John's River and the cold weather. See, birds' feathers have natural oils, which help propel water. But Cindy told me contaminants in the river have stripped the pelicans of those oils.
You're outside, you're, you know, soaking wet in your clothes, then you went to air conditioning, you would not be comfortable, and eventually, you know, if your temperature kept dropping, you'd die.
Cindy also worries the birds aren't eating because they can't tolerate being out in the cold air. In order to prevent more birds from dying, she's bringing the sick birds to her sanctuary, where the pelicans are being washed and cared for until their natural oils return. Then they'll be released back into the wild. Right now, only pelicans are being affected, but Cindy worries that down the road, other birds will also face the same illnesses and even death. Reporting on Big Talbot Island, Ashley Coleman, CBS 47 Action News.
When you whip around the grocery store, do you ever think about germs? Jennifer Carr does.
Most carts are very disgusting. There's lots of germs. I'm very germophobic. I've worked in the daycare facility.
Because of that, Carr isn't taking any chances with her one-year-old daughter. She sits on top of a cover every time she goes to the store to make sure she stays germ-free.
She's touching what I have washed, not what someone else has washed.
Many stores provide antibacterial wipes to wipe down the cart handles, but one local store is taking it even further. Winn-Dixie says it doesn't want to take any chances when it comes to keeping its customers safe. That's why it's taking a proactive approach to fighting germs. Winn-Dixie teamed up with a South Florida company to bring mobile sanitizing units to their stores. The units act like a car wash. The shopping carts are cleaned with a high-temperature, pressurized water mix, then sterilized with hydrogen peroxide and ultraviolet light. Hunter Robinson with Winn-Dixie says it even has government backing.
The product is EPA and USDA approved, so we know it's perfectly safe.
Once the carts dry, they're hosed down with a water-based coating. It keeps equipment germ-free for 6 months.
It bonds to the cart, so anything that touches the cart will instantly be killed by this bonding.
For her daughter's sake, Carr hopes so. Regardless, she'll continue to be mindful and keep an eye on pesky germs lurking at her fingertips.
Rickle, bye-bye.